Hi, welcome back. In this video, I want to go over some changes that have occurred in Infinite Campus as of 2/15/2021. We'll focus on some of the changes related to creating assignments and how those buttons and screens have a different look and feel than they did previously. So when you go to create an assignment and you click the Add button, you'll notice next to the Add button now there's a drop-down arrow. If you just click the Add button, it will go to create an assignment like it usually did, but if you click the drop-down arrow, you're going to see you have other choices as well, such as Folder, Resource, Assignment, Discussion, Quiz, and Submission. So I'm going to choose Assignment, and now immediately you'll notice that the screen is different than you're used to seeing. So I'll just title this assignment Example. If you need to give a summary, you can add some text right here in this box. You can also add attachments or notes here. On the right-hand side here, you see you have where it says Section Settings. You can make this visible to the class or not by toggling the switch. You can give it a start date and an end date, and you can select specific students if you need to from this list. If you click this button right here, your list of students will pop up. For the purposes of this video, I'm graying out the names of the students, but over here on the left-hand side, you can check or uncheck those specific students, and then you'll be able to also give them custom dates if you need to right here by checking a box and selecting a date to make that specific to an individual student. Under grading, you should see the same options that you had before. It's just going to be laid out a little bit differently, and you can select those choices that you normally would make right here. Give it a point value. It lets you add the scoring rubric right here. And then down here, this is the part that's a little different. If you want to copy it to different sections, it says right here, available to edit after saving. So what I need to do first is I need to go down here and save this. After I have all of the other things set for this assignment, I click Save. Then once I click Save, I'm able to add or edit the other sections that this is going to be going to, like a copy is going to be made for these sections. I'll click Add/Edit here. Then it brings up my current class, and now I'd have to go down here to the button that says Add Sections. I click that. Now I see my other sections, and now I'm able to choose which sections this is going to get copied to. So for this example, I'm going to add it to one more section right here. Now you can see down here I have two classes that this is going to be added to in this what's called the section selector at the top. And now again, you can review here which classes this is being sent out to. At the bottom, you can click Save Changes. Now I can see right here is the example assignment that I just created. So it is in this class right here. I'm also going to double check that it did copy to the other class, which should be right here. Let's take a look at that. So here we are in the other section right here, and this is the assignment at the very end right here, the example assignment. So it did in fact copy over to this other class period. That'll do it for this video. I want to keep it sort of on the short side, and that was just to help you navigate through those new screens to make sure you know how to copy assignments to those multiple sections. If you have any questions, please email me at kbollendorf@fleetwoodasd.org. Until next time, have a great day.